Yes, dear students, I welcome you all back to the session. So today's topic is a new topic, which is usability and accessibility testing. So what is usability testing? So mainly usability focuses on the look and feel of your application. So whenever you visit any website or use any application, so you should have that good feeling to use the application, right? And also the look of the application should be good, which means that it should have a proper font size, or the picture should be in a proper format and proper size. So all these, and the usage aspects of the product should also be considered from the point of view of the user. So end user point of view will be considered and application will be developed. And some of the factors that fuel the debate on usability are, so usability and look and feel aspects are subjective in nature and cannot always be objectively measured. So sometimes these are just subjective to some of the natures of your application. So if your application is dynamic and has some graphics in it, or some user-friendly aspects in it, so it should be you have to be concentrating on usability testing. And it cannot be always method to concentrate on. And the perceptions of good usability varies from user to user. I want my website to look like this, and somebody else has the different opinion. So it again different. It again varies from the user to user. And user interface can be constructed as a design time activity. And also something that is easily for one user may not be easy for another user, due to different types of users of a product can have. So for example, for me, using the irctc.com is very easy, but someone else will have a difficulty in using it because they feel that it is not user friendly, right? And something what is considered by fast by one user may not be the same, so it can be slow for the other user. So whatever I grasp is different, and the other person who understands is different. And something that is considered beautiful by someone may look ugly for another. So the same point. So something looks beautiful for me, but not for the other person. Maybe their logo looks good to me. Any company logo, for example, IBM company logo looks good to me, but the other person may not like it, right? And the view expressed by one user of the product may not be the view of the other person. So that's what. So it mainly very different for different users. So I may think my website is very good because I have developed it and I have given the inputs, and I have my own choices to put what kind of images and what kind of fonts. But the other person may not like it because everybody's taste is different. And let us see some of the characters of the usability testing. So usability testing tests the product from the user point of view. Like I have told you, you should always concentrate on end user point of view. So if your application is user friendly, then many users will come and use your application. And usability testing is for checking the product to see if it is easy to use for various categories of users or not. So for example, banking application, so whether it is useful for the person who doesn't know anything about accounts or not. So all such applications are developed considering the different categories, right? So because I am being technical, I will understand the application, and a banker will also understand the banking application, but somebody from arts background will not be able to understand the banking application quickly. And usability testing is a process to identify the discrepancy between the user interface of the product and the human user requirements. So you need to find out what are all the problems or discrepancies between the interface and the product and also the human user requirements. So your requirements are meeting the developed application or not. Next, we'll see what is the approach to usability test. So when doing the usability testing, certain human factors to be considered in a qualifiable way and can be tested objectively. So the number of mouse clicks and the number of sub menus to navigate and number of keystrokes and number of commands to perform the task can all be measured and also checked as a part of usability testing. So what in usability testing you do is you just go through the application and you just see that the transaction to perform is very short way. So for example, in banking application, transferring money is the main feature, which should happen in very minor clicks, right? So it should not be n number of clicks or n number of menus you need to go through. So it should be easy to use. And so usability testing is not only for the product binaries or executables. So it also applies to the documentation and other deliverables that are shipped along with the product. It can be your user manual or it can be anything related to your service level agreements. So all the documents should be also tested. And another aspect of usability is with respect to the messages that a system gives to the user. And messages are classified into three types, which are formal and warning and also an error. So a system should intelligently detect the detect and avoid wrong messages and wrong usages. And if a wrong usage cannot be avoided, it should be provided appropriate and meaningful messages to the user. And lastly, the usability should not be confused with graphical user interface. So usability should not be confused with the graphical user interface. So which is best suited for the people to perform usability testing? So typically representative of the actual user segments who would be using the product, and so that the typical user pattern can be captured. So normally user, how does he perform the actions in the application can be seen. And people who are new to the product, so that they can start without any bias and be able to identify usability problems. And also a part of team will be performing usability testing. It is selected from the representative outside the testing team, because the one who does the testing may not be always finding out the errors. So he can approach the other person outside the team. So what are the means to verify usability design? It can be style sheet, it can be screen prototypes, paper design and layout designs. So style sheets are actually grouping of user interface design, which includes the design elements, and use of style sheet ensure consistency of the design elements across several screens. And screen prototyping is another way to test the usability. So the screens are designed as they are designed, as they will be shipped to the customer. Exactly as the shipment to the customer, you have to design it in that way. And paper design explores the earliest opportunity to validate the usability design, and much more actual design of the coding is done for the product. And layout design style sheet ensure that the sheet of the user interface elements are grouped and used repeatedly together. Next, let us see how to achieve this usability. And involving the users proactively on the user interface design can actually yield the good result. So you have to be involved in the user interface which is provided to you, so which results in good good amount of results. And user requirements cannot be expressed in terms of the words. So it cannot be expressed in terms of words. You can have a pictorial representation, or you can have a flow diagram, or you can have an activity diagram. So one has to use the product to get feel of its usability. So whenever I buy something, then only I will be able to judge the item or product. So this is not always possible because the user may not have time or bandwidth to participate in this exercise. Sometimes the user doesn't have a time or he doesn't have a bandwidth for it to participate in the activity. And there may be number of users who may give conflicting requirements, and it would be not possible to satisfy everyone. So that's what, everybody's point of view will be different. So you cannot consider everybody's opinion and develop the product. In case of breakthrough products, the user may not be able to visualize the usage of the product. So quality factors for the usability are, so these helps in improving the objectivity of the product and testing. So comprehensibility, the product should have simple and logical structure of the feature and also the documentation. And consistency, so the product needs to be consistent with any applicable standard or platform, or it can be the look and feel, or it can be the base infrastructure or the earlier version of the style same product. And navigation, so this helps in determining how easy it is to select the different operations of the product. And responsiveness is basically how fast the product responds to the user request. So it is actually a very important aspect of the usability testing. So this completes your usability testing. So next we will move on to accessibility testing in the next session. Thank you all.